चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्याये सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। ॐ ब्रह्मानन्दं परमसुखं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमः। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भा शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमा अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ता वन्दे गुरुपरं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनि व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये।
यत्साङ्ख्यै प्राप्यते स्थानम् तद्योगैरपि गम्यते इति स्मृतं फलैकत्वम् योगिनां च विवेकिनां। सो द इन्क्वायरी इन्टु द रिजल्ट फल एक्सेट्रा ऑफ बोथ योग एंड ज्ञान इज बीइंग कंडक्टेड फ्रॉम चांदा 80 to 89। ज्ञान योग यो नॉट ज्ञान योग ड्यूअल इज देयर ओके नॉट ज्ञान योग दैट वाज ज्ञान योग स्टेटेड एज इट ज्ञान योग यो ऑफ ज्ञान एंड योग ज्ञान योग यो फलादि विचारः नॉट वन वर्ड ज्ञान योग ज्ञान योगस्य इतुडेड ज्ञान योग यो फलादि विचारः फ्रॉम स्कंद 80 to 89। So the claim of this Purapaksha is that maybe this Viveka Vijnana will help us to ascertain that Atma is Pretama, but certainly it can't give us a Paroksha Jnana which can give moksha. For that the answer is given, no, Viveka Vijnana certainly can give the Aparoksha Jnana which can give the moksha. And in this context, we are now the question was, that is, Pramana also cited. Lord Krishna has told in Gita, so yat sankhyai prapyate sthanam tad yogairapi gamyate. So ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati sa pashyati. So one who knows that both are one and the same means they are for the same, that means result, so he knows the real exact nature of both yoga and sankhya. How is it we have seen in terms of Sankara Bhashya. Now the question was, if it is so that yoga and sankhya are meant for aparoksha jnana and thereby moksha, why at all these two, that means two methods are given? See, only one can be given, otherwise confusion can be there. For that it was said, it is because of adhikara vaichitra. Adhikara vaichitra, because of the different types of the mumukshus that are available. So this is given. So in this context, we are seeing the role of yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, Patanjali Yoga. So Ashtanga Yoga, Patanjali Yoga is certainly a means to treat the mind. Yoga Shastrasya Chitta Chikitsaka Samadhi Matre Pravruttatva Nirodha Samadhau Atma Darshanam Tatra Na Sakshad Uttam. So that means there directly Atma Darshana, Atma Jnana is not told, it is not at all anywhere in that. But indirectly it can be arrived, that is what it says. But one thing, by this Samadhi, as given by Patanjali Yoga, Yoga Suchitta Vritti Nirodha, one can get that absorbed state of the mind wherein one can appreciate the Tvampada, which is Shuddha Tvampada. Shuddha Tvampada means Nirupadhika. So I, free from all upadhis, pure Chaitanya can be appreciated. But thereby alone, that means by that alone, one cannot hope to gain moksha, because the identity between one's real nature, Shuddha Tvampada, and Tatpada, Brahma, cannot be gained by just that, having that experience of Andha Samadhi. So such a yogi has to take recourse to Shruti, to by inquiry, and one has to discover that the Tvampada and Tatpada, Shuddhataya, Shuddhataya, both are one and the same. So he has to take recourse to Shruti. So therefore, Nirodha Samadhina Shodhite Tvam Padarthe Sakshat Kriti Ati Tasya Brahmatva Gocharitum Mahavakena Brahma Vidya Namakam Vrityantaram Utpadyate. So what is to be done is, one has to take to Brahma Vidya, and thereby that Akhandakara Vritti has to take place, wherein he discovers the identity of one's real nature with that of Brahma. Then only it is possible to gain the moksha. And also he has to fast the reality of the upadhis and the world. Otherwise what will happen? So long as he is in the Andha Samadhi, all is fine. Moment he Uttana Samaya comes, reality of the upadhi and the jagat will be there. So that, because ignorance is still there, so therefore Shruti he has to take. So the question is it that Shuddha Tvampada, which is free from all drishya, can be appreciated only by this Ashtanga Yoga? Is it that Samadhi alone can give that appreciation? Is there no other method? No. The Ashtanga Yoga is one of the methods to appreciate the Shuddha Tvampada. So that means that is the pure Chaitanya free from all the drishya is one of the techniques, that's all. That is not the only way. So therefore you say Viveka Vijnana also can give the very same appreciation of Shuddha Tvampada as gained by the Ashtanga Yogi. So therefore you say Vidyaranya continues, Nacha Shuddha Tvampada Sakshatkare Nirodha Samadhi Ekaha Eva Upayaha. Nacha Shuddha Tvampada Sakshatkare Nirodha Samadhi Ekaha Eva Upayaha. That's what it says is, Shuddha Tvampada Sakshatkare, for the appreciation of Tvampada, is Shuddha free from all drishya, Nirodha Samadhi Ekaha Eva Upayaha Nacha. Nirodha Samadhi. Nirodha Samadhi is the Samadhi of what the Patanjali Yoga speaks. Therefore, that Samadhi alone is not the means. Then what? Kintu, whereas, Chijjada Vivekenapi Prithakrute Tatsakshatkara Sambhava. Chijjada Vivekenapi, by the Viveka, discrimination of Chit Chaitanya Sarupa Atma, Jada, which is Anatma, as we have done here. That is, Atmasu Kamaya Sarvam Priyambhavati. Atma is Priyatama. Other things are Anatma. Other things are, whether it is Gauna Atma or Mithya Atma, they are Anatma. Mukhya Atma alone is the one which is the Priya Priyatama. So this Chijjada Viveka, Atma Anatma Viveka. By this, by ascertainment of that is the what is one's own real nature, and also ascertaining the Mithya Atma of Anatma, so thereby also what can be done is, Kintu Chijjada Vivekenapi Prithakrute Tat Sakshatkara Sambhava. Tat Sakshatkara is Shuddha Tvampada Sakshatkara Sambhava. And with the Shruti, with the help of the Shruti, this can be also, this has to be done with the help of the Shruti. And Shruti is very clear about the identity between the Siddhatvampada. What Siddhatvampada means? Real nature of Jiva. So, the appreciation of pure Chaitanya free from all the Drishya. So, that is same as Brahma, that is what is unfolded by Shruti. So, that way, so, Patanjali Yoga can give us a technique of being a Chikitsa. Treating the mind to get an absorbed state of it. That way it can, that is one of the techniques. The question arises, to what extent? In the modern context it is practical. And to what extent those who claim the yogas are capable of teaching it? More or less, nowadays, at best it is going on at the level of some asanas and pranayama. If you speak from therapeutical standpoint, well and good, we have nothing to say as well. But if it means for moksha, Ashtanga Yoga certainly can provide a technique, but from the practical standpoint, really speaking, I myself don't know how real such great masters are there. Maybe they, and if at all they are there, I doubt whether they will be in the marketplace. They may be somewhere, we can't say. But whether they will be available in the marketplace is a big question. Let us not enter into that. Okay. But this is what the role of the Ashtanga Yoga from the standpoint of gaining the knowledge, gaining moksha. Now with this back, that means backdrop, now let us see these two stanzas. Actually Vidyaranya brings these stanzas there after one stanza, but before that there is other stanza we have seen. But those who have got Achyutraya Bodhak's Tika, there you can find that. Before that Asadhya Kaschid Yoga, there is a stanza there. Dvau kramau chittanashasya yogo jnanam cha raghava. Lord Ramchandraji is being taught by Vasishtha. Chittanashasya dvau kramau. That means there are two methods of getting that chittanashaya, is that getting that absorbed state of the mind. So the context was atma saustam manaskritva makinchidapi chintaye. So preoccupation to the mind is atma darshana, appreciation of one's own real nature, but no other thoughts, etc., no other drishya has to be allowed to come in. That and that alone has to be the preoccupation at that time. So, chittanashasya yogaha jnanam cha raghava. So, that is dvau kramau. There are two ways of doing that. One is yoga, the other is jnanam. What is yoga? What is the jnana? Yogaha tad vritti rodha hi. Yoga is tad vritti rodha, that is chitta vritti rodha, tad stands for chitta. So yoga is chitta vritti rodha, whereas jnanam samyagavekshanam. Jnana is samyagavekshanam, means appreciation of the real nature by ascertaining the nishyatva and appreciation of satya swarupa atma brahma. So this has to be taken in the context of atma samsam manasritva, means a person who has already gained the aparoksha jnana, but he wants to take to now nididhyasana. Atma vare drashtavyaha, srotavyaha, mantavyaha, nididhyasitavyaha. Why taking to nididhyasana? No doubt aparoksha jnana is there, means that preoccupation that he has to give to the mind is certainly there because he knows what is real nature. But at that time of taking nididhyasana, if it is, so that is, the vikshepa has come because of other vrittis, here is a technique what is to be done. In that context, that has been told there to Ramachandraji. So, in that context, now he says, take the stanza now. Asadhya kasyachid yogaha. Kasyachid jnana nishchayaha. Ittham vicharya margau dvau. Jagad Parameshwarah. Kasyachit yogaha asadhya. Kasyachit jnana nishchayaha asadhya. Ittham vicharya Parameshwarah dvau margau jagad. Kasyachit, for some people, yogaha asadhya. Here yoga we have to take as yoga. Ashtanga only. We are Ashtanga only. karma yoga, if you take, we'll see how it is. It also can be taken, but the more, that means the more that is conscious, or it is more apt to take as yoga because of the further discussion that the Pura Paksha is bringing there. To some people, yoga ha asadhya, in the sense, karma yoga, is it that asadhya? No, but still asadhya also, we'll see that afterwards. First let us see, if we take yoga as Patanjali yoga, because the context was that Chitta Nasha, etc. Therefore yoga is Patanjali yoga here. Asadhya means possible for many, it is not possible, for some it is not possible. Okay. So, that is one thing. Kasyachit jnana nishtayaha asadhya. For others or for some, ascertainment of knowledge of oneself is asadhya, impossible. Actually impossible here, it can be taken. Not totally impossible, but difficult. Na sadhya, alparthe na can be taken there. Na sadhya, difficult. Karma yoga also can be taken as difficult. How? Karma yoga without karma is possible? No. Karma means lot of fears are involved. Samagri has to be procured. That much of preoccupation is there. That way one may say it is difficult. This of, actually this is, that means this Pura Paksha picks up afterwards. So that is, for a person may be there who may not take to, in that means the actual karma, but he can take to inquiry. If the proper frame of mind and readiness of the mind is there, other person may not be available for inquiry, but he is ready to take too many things. It's possible depending on the texture of the individual. Okay. Just like it, to some people, yoga is impossible or difficult. Either way, you can take the Ashtanga yoga or Karma yoga, but more precisely, difficult in the sense Ashtanga yoga. Kasyachit jnana nishtayaha asadhyaha, ascertainment of knowledge in terms of inquiry is difficult for others. Itham vicharya, that means thinking through, having taken into account such different capacities of the mumukshus, parameshwaraha dvau margau jagada. The Lord has told jagada, has told dvau margau, two paths as we have seen, yoga and jnana, lokesmin vividhanishtha, two styles of living, yoga and jnana. Lord has told jagada, vitvalit of gad gadati. So jagada, Lord has told these two, yoga and jnana. So therefore you can't question why these two have been told there, why confusion has come. It is according to the capacity of the individual, one has to take to that. Now, Pura Paksha comes up. He says, how can you equate yoga with Viveka Jnana? So you only told no, for some it is asadhya. Asadhya means difficult, is it not? Huh? If that were the a difficult thing, it should be superior or inferior. If there is one difficult thing, then the other thing is simple. Which should be superior? Difficult, is it not? So therefore, yoga is difficult. This Pura Paksha stands. Yoga is difficult. So therefore, certainly there must be some excellence in yoga compared to your Viveka Vidyana, which is easy. What is Viveka Vidyana? Fellow sitting somewhere in the corner and they have nothing else to do, and then what? Go on. Go on, that is thinking, etc. That is easy to do. But yoga is very difficult. So how can you put both these at par? Durga Pura Paksha, but doubt. Nanu, atyanta ayasa siddha sadhyasya yoga. What is yoga? Atyanta ayasa sadhyasya. Which can be accomplished by great effort, not just easy to take to. One side. Nirayasa sulabhad vivekad. And Viveka, which gives you jnana, is nirayasa, without any ayasa, without any effort at all, easy to gain. Therefore, what is to be done? Atishayaha vaktavyaha. Certainly, we should tell about some excellence or some superiority on the part of the yoga with respect to Viveka, which leads to jnana. It is difficult to take, very difficult to accomplish. We can't put both with both at par. You know that we're saying Takeshara Khaji, Takeshara Bhaji, Takeshara Khaja. Northern side, not in South. Southern side. That side, everyone is familiar with that. Takeshara Bhaji, Takeshara Khaja. Taka, Taka means a coin in olden days. I hope you know Anas, etc. Our 6 paisa was equal to Anas. Somewhere around that value, and Taka is a coin. Not even anywhere near rupee. Three paisa, okay, 3 paisa. Yeah, that is half an hour, that paisa, not naya paisa. Yes, three naya paisa, correct. Yes, half an hour. Half an hour means 3 naya paisa. Taka. Olden days, before this currency came. Okay, that's taka. Takeshara Bhaji, Takeshara Khaja. There was a kingdom where the bhaji, you know, vegetable. The price of vegetable is share means 1 share. What that we got somewhere half pound or something like that. Somewhere around half pound or something. Two pounds, okay. That is 2 pounds. 2 pounds is 1 share. So therefore, 1 share of bhaji, 2 pounds of bhaji cost 1 taka. Khaja means sweetmeat. So that also, what is the cost of that? Cost that also 2 pounds, 1 taka. And if you want to take ghee, taka share, only one rate in the kingdom. I don't know whether diamonds also were given at the rate of taka share. Anyway, whether it is precious thing or cheap thing, taka share. So there is no distinction at all. There is a story to this effect. That reveal the, that means the, what actually is the import behind it. It seems one guru along with 2 disciples was just the Parivrajaka. He was moving. While moving, he came to a particular place, a kingdom. So he was at the outskirts of the kingdom, and it was time for them to have bhiksha. So therefore, as usual, both the disciples, guru was there, and both disciples went to the place to get the bhiksha on different sides. It happened because they were on the border of the kingdom. The one disciple went to different place, the other disciple went to a place where this Takashara Bhaji, Takashara Khaja. He went everywhere, he got some money, and he went to the shop to get something. He asked the price of different things. No surprise, everything, which is, that means, with the ordinary thing also, is the rate is Takashara, and even the costly things also Takashara. So he asked in many shops, he found the same thing. So he was very happy, went to a sweetmeat shop, and took lots of sweets. And then what? He went back to the guru. By that time, other person also had come with little meager, that means bhiksha, he could get. So now they are sharing, that means giving to the guru, and they are sharing among themselves. So at that time, this bhiksha told, it is like this in the kingdom, etc. The guru said, is it so? He said, let us not stay here, let us quit as early as possible from here. What does it reflect? The ruler of the kingdom must be idiot. And it is never advisable to stay in such kingdom. You know that in olden days the custom was people were moving from place to place. And suppose in the, there were no hotels. But in the evening when they have to stay somewhere in the village, etc., first thing they have to verify whether in that village there is a temple or not. If there is no temple, don't stay in the village. It reflects very bad on the nature of the people. Means if temple is there, means they are devoted to the Lord. They will not take to, generally they will not take to adharmic acts. That is safer. Otherwise you can verify. Nowadays people don't take care of it, but they suffer. What happened from the Kuwait people? A few years back or 1.5 years back. Anyway, Mother India is there to send the planes and bring the fellows here at its cost as such. Is it not? Indian Airlines is there. What happened? Same thing. Place where you have no freedom of worship, etc., be very careful. Because a ruler you can never rely upon. Because Saddam Hussein or whoever it may be. So that means there are different varieties. Okay. Now, when he said, when he was, that means he told, because if this is the case, ruler must be a certain an idiot, better don't stay here. But that, the disciples needed, sir, Bhagavan, I will say, okay, you can say, but we don't want to say. The other disciple and the guru left. And this fellow was happy, so there's so much of fruit, etc., etc. And then every day he was going for bhiksha and getting and lots of sweet. Within no time he became tagda. So therefore he became fat. Now what happened? Now the trouble started. So one day, suddenly soldiers came and started dragging him. After food, he was reclining under a shade, under the shade of a tree. They started dragging him. He said, what are you doing? Nothing doing, come along with us. And the fellow was taken to the gallows. He is to be hanged. What have I done? I am not doing nothing doing. You, that is this. What actually had transpired was, definitely happened at one place, somebody's wall had collapsed. Of brick had collapsed. And the neighbor's goat got killed. Therefore, the owner of the goat went to the king and he said, I want justice. What is that? My goat is killed. On account of what? He said, because of neighbor's fault. Neighbor was summoned. He said, is it so? He said, now the culprit has to punish, is it not? He said, but yes, Maharaj, it is true. But what can I do? It is the fault of the mason. The mason has not erected the wall properly. Oh, is it so? The owner of the neighbor was left and the mason was fault. Mason was, why did you not construct the wall properly? Maharaj, what can I do? See, the person who was to supply the water for making the mixture, the concrete mixture, cement mixture, he didn't put the proper water as such. Therefore, the cement was not that strong enough. Therefore, the wall collapsed. It is not my mistake at all. Achha, it is not your mistake. Okay. Where is the person who had supplied the water for that? He was summoned. So why did you not put proper quantity of water in mixing of the cement? He said, Maharaj, what can I do? When I was putting the water, at that time, the minister was passing with all paraphernalia. My mind got distracted. I started looking at the minister. Therefore what? The sufficient quantity of water was not put in the cement mixture. Whose fault is it? Minister. Minister was first. Did you pass by that time? No, what did he do? He did pass by that region. So, yes, Maharaj, but I have nothing to do. I was on the official duty, sir. Nothing to do. Why did you go with the paraphernalia, etc., to distract the mind of the people around, etc.? You are the culprit, therefore what? You should be hanged. No pleading. Minister can't anything, and the king gave the verdict, and the minister was taken to the gallows. So what happened? Well, there while hanging, the noose can't fit to the... it can't fit into the neck of the minister, because he was slim, whereas the noose was big. The person who was to execute tried his best, but he can't escape. He said, Maharaj, it is not possible because he is a thin fellow and the noose is that big one. It is not possible. What is to be done? The king gave the order. Find out from the kingdom if there is a fat fellow. And found this fellow reclining there and dragged. Now he said, my God, now I am going to die. As he pleaded, I am a sadhu, I have nothing to do, etc. Nothing doing. You are fat, therefore what? You are going to be hanged as such. Guru was shrewd enough. He knew some calamity is bound to befall him. He had not left the particular country totally. He was just. And the news came to him that this boy is in danger. along with other disciples, immediately rushed where he was to be executed. And he told the king, look, he is my disciple. We can execute him. But we believe that before he is hanging a person, whatever the person's wish is that it is to be fulfilled. That is the general custom. I would like to talk to him. The king agreed to that. The guru took the disciple aside and whispered something in the ear. And both of them came to the Maharaj and said, Guru said that Maharaj, please don't hang him. You hang me. Whereas the disciples, the one who was pleading for mercy, that disciple said, Maharaj, no. I am the fat person. I am the one who is fit to get hanged. Not my, and he is my guru. Don't hang him. You hang me. Both of them were pleading with the king with such a pity that we request. Doubt now. What is the reason? You know this fellow, this tagda fellow, pleading for mercy. Now he is so eager that he should be hanged, and the guru also is equally eager that he should be hanged. What is he saying? Why both of you are asking me to hang me? Hang me. This particular moment is so auspicious. Part of yoga. This is because of the fact that yoga is capable of aparoksha jnana. These are the questions asked to the Purapaksha, who says that yoga is superior. Kim aparoksha jnana janakatvad uchyate. We say that it is because of it is capable of giving aparoksha jnana. Kuta or number two. Raga dvesha adi nivrutti hetutva. We mean to say yoga is capable of eliminating the raga dvesha. Is it because of that you would like to claim the superiority of the yoga? Or number three, the question is Sava. Dvaitanupalabdhi karanatha. You need to say, because of dvaita, because of yoga, there is dvaitanupalabdhi. Means absence of the dvaita. This dvaita is eliminated. You mean to say that is because samadhi is there, means drishya is not available. You mean to say because dvaita is, that means this dvaita is not available in that state. Is it because of that kiti vikalpya, means having divided, that means having made the divisions in terms of knowing his intention as to why the yoga is superior? Then the answer is given by one now. For each vikalpa, that means for each division, possibilities, the answer is being given. Now, first, prathama pakshe, phala samyam ityah. Now, look at, comparison is between now, vivek yoga, as he claims, and viveka vidyan. So, now, the question is it that you claim the superiority of yoga over viveka vijnana because yoga is capable of aparoksha jnana? Is it so? In that case, viveka vijnana also equally confers the aparoksha jnana. You can't have any superiority on that at all. Yoge ko tishayas tetra. Jnana muktam samam dvayoho. Raga dveshadya bhavasya. Tulyo yogi vivekinoho. Atra yogi saha atishayaha. Te atra you take. Te atra yogi. कहा अतिशयः ते अत्र योगे कहा अतिशयः द्वयोहु ज्ञानम समम उक्तम. द्वयोहु एड दैट आफ्टर द्वयोहु एड अत्र ज्ञानम समम उक्तम. Okay, you take last one first. Yogi vivekinoho dvayoho. Last phrase. Yogi vivekinoho dvayoho add atra jnanam samam uktam. Cha ragadveshadi abhavaha tulyaha. Cha ragadveshadi abhavaha ragadveshadi abhavaha tulyaha. So this is answer for second alternative, for second possibility. Now let us see. First thing, atra. Atra means, if you compare between, that compare yoga and the Viveka Vijnana, among these two. Yoge kaha atishayaha. What is atishaya? What is the plus factor or excellence in yoga in comparison to Viveka Vijnana? If you compare with Viveka Vijnana, what is that which is something additional in your yoga? Why? Because this is the reason that there is nothing like that, because yogi vivekinoho dvayoho. So for both these, the yogi and viveki in the sense, in the Vedana Viveka, who has ascertained the Atma Swarupa. So that Viveki and yogi also, who had taken to yoga, finally discovered oneself. That is there, because that we have seen, just yoga itself will not give him the moksha. So therefore, that type of yogi. So yogi vivekinoho dvayoho, among these two, he says samam jnanam samam muktam. So jnana is said to be the same, means both have got the aparoksha jnana. Where is it said? We have seen. Yat sankhyaihi prapyate sthanam tad yogairapi gamyate. Gita, 5th chapter, 5th skanda. It was in the skanda 82 here. Okay. So therefore, we have nothing to claim as superior in terms of yoga, because aparoksha jnana is for by Viveka Vijnana also. The second possibility is, no, by yoga, raga dveshas are eliminated, or one can get freed from the reactions of raga dveshas. If you say so, that is what it says. And raga dveshad abhavascha tulyaha. Absence of raga dvesha also is tulya, means common in both yogi and viveki. Just as the yogi is free from raga dvesha, so also viveki also is. Viveki means this one who has got vijnana, knowledge with the help of viveka as told. So he also is free from raga dvesha. So on that account also, you can't claim any superiority for yoga. Now, how do you say so? That for viveki, raga dvesha are not there. How is he free from raga dvesha? That is deduced. Vivekinaha ragadyabhavam upapadayati. So in the case of Viveki, who has got that knowledge by such discrimination, he has not got the raga dvesha is shown. Continuing, na priti vishayeshvasti preyanatmeti janataha. Kuto raga kuto dveshaha pratikulyam apashyatah atma priyan iti janatah. Atma priyan iti janatah vishayeshu प्रीति न अस्ति. प्रीति विषयेषु अस्ति. विषयेषु प्रीति न अस्ति. कैन ऐड
अतः कुतः रागः
कुतः रागः भवति
प्रातिकूल्यम् अपश्यतः द्वेषः कुतः भवति
भवति टु बी एडेड बोथ न्यूज
प्रातिकूल्यम् अपश्यतः द्वेषः कुतः भवति
सो हु इज दिस विवेकी
नॉट द विवेकी टोल्ड इन विवेक चूडामणि ओके
देयर दैट इज हियर स्पीकर हियर विवेक इज बाय सच विवेक एज टोल्ड हियर वन हैज गेन्ड द अपरोक्ष ज्ञान ऑफ आत्मा
आत्मा प्रेयान इति जानतः
He has got the knowledge that Atma is Preyan.
Oneself is Priyatamaha.
So Atma Preyan.
So oneself is Priyatama.
So this Viveki, here Viveki is as, that is, as inquiry was conducted and who has gained the knowledge, not any Viveki. Because that in that context only the question was asked by the Purapaksha.
Atma Preyan iti Janataha.
So therefore for the one Viveki who knows that Atma is Priyatama, oneself is the most dear. If that is the case, what is his attitude towards other things? Has he got Priti for other things? If Atma is most dear, one who has discovered this truth, will he have fascination for rest of the Anatma Vishayas?
No. Because he has discovered the what is that is most, and why Atma is most dear? Paramananda Swarupataha, because it is Paramananda Swarupa.
So therefore,
Suti Janata, for the one who knows, Vishayeshu Pritihi Nasti.
He has no love for sense objects. He has no value for sense objects, because he knows for certain. He is knowing, not just knowing that it, Atmajnana is already there. Vishayeshu Pritihi Nasti.
Therefore, Ataha, Kutaha Ragaha Bhavati. How can he have Raga?
That means love or hankering for the sense object Vishaya. He cannot have. Because he knows that Atma is Priyatama Ananda Paramananda Swarupa. So he can't have any hankering for sense object.
Okay. He may not have hankering for sense object. He may have vesha for some sense object.
No.
Pratikulyam apashyatah.
See,
raga is possible when anukulya is there.
Is it not?
Raga hankering is possible provided anukulya,
a favorable disposition towards a particular object, being or event is there.
Then raga is possible. Now you see, for vesha, what should be there? Pratikulya disposition is required.
So that this is not conducive for me. The source of sorrow, like that should be there.
He says, Pratikulya, now for him, even Dvesha also is not there. Before that, Raga Hetoho Anukulya Jnanasya Abhavat Teshu Ragaha Na Jayate.
Why Raga is not there? Tikakara has explained.
Raga hetoho anukulya jnanasya bhava.
The cause of raga hankering is anukulya.
Means favorable disposition. That itself is not there. Why is it not there?
Atma priyatamaha.
So therefore, he cannot have raga. Nati dvesha. Dvesha also is not possible. Why? Tad hetoho.
Tad hetoho. Dvesha se hetoho. The cause of dvesha. Means that which produces dvesha. What is it?
Pratikulya jnanasya abhava.
That something is unfavorable, hostile. This notion is not there. Why is it not there?
Atma priyatama has been discovered, and in that knowledge, everything else is mithya, has been asserted.
So therefore, from the standpoint of the vision of real nature of oneself, which is Paramananda Swarupa, he doesn't have such notion that something is pratikula, which is something is unfavorable to me, that notion is not there. Dvesha, that means the hatred or disagreeable disposition also is not there in this case. So, if your yogi is free from raga dvesha,
One who is Viveki and thereby Vijnanavan has got.
Also equally three prongs.
On this account also you can't claim superiority for Viveki. That is left out. Another question is, Purapaksha is not ready to accept. Purapaksha's contention is, Yogi is free from Raga Dvesha, but your Viveki is not free from Raga Dvesha. Why is it not? That is because we find this Viveki who has got Jnana during his Vyavahara time, he has also got the Raga Dvesha. During Vyavahara time, he has got the Raga Dvesha. So therefore, you can't claim freedom of Raga Dvesha for a Viveka Vijnani. That is the Yogi's contention. Let us see that the speaker.
Nanu Vivekinaha Vyavahara Dashaya Deha Dupadravakarishu Veshaha Drishyate Iti Asha.
What you find in the case of Viveki, Vyavahara Dashaya, when he deals with the world, we do find Vesha. So where?
Dehadi Upadravakarishu.
So I found him there other day just hitting like this and killing a mosquito.
Vesha or not?
See, I am the eyewitness. He has killed a mosquito. Or at least if not killed because of his sannyasi, he has taken he has given abhaya for everyone. And he has driven away the mosquito.
Vesha is there or not?
He drew away the mosquito. So Vesha is there.
Vipadravakarishu.
Those which give affliction to the body, etc. In this thing, Veshaha Drishyate. We do find in the case of a jnani, the Vesha. He says, if that is your contention, your yogi also is no better. Okay?
Your yogi also, Vyavahara Dashaya. He also has got Vesha equally.
Let your yogi get up from Samadhi. What will happen?
Just think all fellows should get away from here.
Otherwise, at times it happens, some people say. Somebody does every day japa. The moment the fellow gets up from japa,
no one should get anywhere near. Last, everyone around to get too angry and get irritated, etc.
So like that, maybe also like that, did not be. Okay. So therefore,
you are yogi also, no better. Vyavahar Dashayam, he also has got Vesha.
So both are in the same boat now, okay? So don't point out about the Vyavahar Dasha of the Viveka Vijnani. Same is in the case of who? Yogi also.
Tada yogi vivekinoho saha tulyaha iti
parivartate. Saha means Tadvesha, in the Vyavahara Dasha, Yogi also has got, Jnani also has got. There is nothing great about that. It is for both, therefore you can't claim any superiority.
Dehade Pratipuleshu Dvesha Tulyo Dvayorati Dvesham Kurvanna Yogi Te Avivekya Pita Drishaha. Dvayoho Api Deha Dehe Pratikuleshu Dveshaha Tulyaha.
Dvayor Api Deha Dehe Pratikuleshu Dveshaha Tulyaha.
Dvesham Kurvan Yogi Na Chet.
Vesham Kurvan Yogi Na Chet
Tadrishaha Aviveki Api.
Tadrishaha Aviveki Api means Na Viveki. Tadrishaha Aviveki Api.
Dvayoho Api
means among these two, for both these two. So for both, who are those both? Now let us keep Yogi and Viveki. Every time the one who has got Jnana, etc. need not be got. So in this context, Viveki means one who has got the Jnana in this man, with this inquiry. So, for both these, Viveki and Yogi, देहादेहे प्रतिकूलेषु द्वेषः तुल्यः
means during vyavahara vyavahar dachayam when they deal with the world
that is the dveshah
the
hatred or disagreeable disposition towards those which are dehadehe pratikulesu those which are pratikula unfavorable or hostile to the body both the cases what is seen dveshah tulyah disagreeable disposition is common in either case, that is in the case of yogi and also in the case of the viveki. Okay. Now the yogi comes, the purapaksha comes, look, if yogi has got dvesha, he is no yogi at all. So that is it. Means, according to me, yogi should not have dvesha at all. Okay, if that is the case, one who has got dvesha, he is not a viveki, that's all. Means what you are taking to account is his assimilation, etc. Means he is not, see, it is possible. A yogi who has got dvesha in the vyavahara dasha, because of his steadfastness in yoga, in course of time, will not have dvesha in the vyavahara dasha also. Earlier he had dvesha in the vyavahara dasha, but because he is so steadfast in yoga, even after getting up from that, he has got that hangover as it were. I mean that means the effect of the yoga is that, so he has no dvesha at all. If that is you are talking of such a person who has got nishtha, I also talk of a person who has got nishtha in the viveka vidyana. So therefore, there also, the viveki who has got so much of nishtha in the knowledge that even if he gets up and he is in the vyavahara dasha, he has no dvesha at all. So therefore, if that is the criterion of your judgment of a yogi, that we should necessarily have that much of nishtha, I will also apply the same norm to whom? Viveki. So therefore, viveki also who has got hatred, dvesha in the vyavahara dasha, he is not at all viveki, he is aviveki. That is what? That is, the norms are same for both. You can't claim superiority. That is what you say. Dvesham kurvan, the one who entertaining dvesha in the vyavahara dasha, yogi na chet, can never be a yogi if you contend like that. In that case, he says, tadrishaha means the viveki who has got dvesha in the vyavahara, he says, tadrishaha aviveki api. Also, he is not a viveki, aviveki api, na viveki. He also, I would also say that he is not a viveki. So therefore, so in any case, you cannot claim any superiority for yoga over viveka. With viveka. Now, there are two vikalpas are answered. What are the two vikalpas? Is it that yoga produces aparoksha jnana, therefore it is superior? Or is it because that is yogi has no raga dvesha, therefore he is superior? No. Answer is given. Third vikalpa was dvaitanupalabdhi. If you say no, in the case of yoga, there is no dvaita at all. Certainly it is vidrishya vinayita, therefore it is certainly superior. If you claim our viveki also has got dvaitanupalabdhi, he also is free from dvaita. Nanu vivekinaha द्वैतदर्शनम् अस्ति योगिनः तन्नास्ति इति तृतीये विकल्पे थर्ड पॉसिबिलिटी व्हाट इज इट थर्ड पॉसिबिलिटी बाय टेकिंग 84 चांदव्यास दैट फॉर विवेकिनः द्वैतदर्शनम् अस्ति ही अप्रिशिएट्स द्वैत प्रपंच ही परसीव्स Whereas yoginastu tannasti, for yogi there is no, that is the cognition of the dvaita rupa jagat, therefore yogi must be superior. If you say so, my dear sir, please let me know, yoginaha atishayaha bhavishyati, therefore tiye vikalpe yoginaha atishayaha bhavishyati iti ashankya. The doubt is, because of this fact, certainly there is superiority in the case of yogi. If you say so, now, let me know, Vivekinaha tadvaita darshanam. You have, that means you have accused. The Purapaksha has accused that Viveki has got dvaita darshanam. And but Yogi doesn't have that. And therefore Yogi is superior. If that is the case, please let me know that the dvaita darshana that you are talking about Viveki, so he is at, in what, that means, in which state is it there? Vivekinaha tadvaita darshanam. Kim vyavahara dashayam uchyate. Are you talking about the dvaita darshana? Appreciation of the dualistic world in the case of Viveki. Is it during the time of vyavahara, means when he deals with the world? Are you talking about that? Uta anyada. Anyada means, or when he is absorbed in the appreciation of Atma Swarupa. Are you talking about the appreciation of Viveki during vyavaharas or anyada? Anyada means, that is, in the state, that is, wherein he is absorbed in the knowledge of oneself. When are you talking? Puti Vikalpya, the answer in the first case is given. Vikalpya, Adde tad yoginaha api samanam iti. Adya means, this is a vyavahara dashayam. Dvaita darshana is equally for yogi. Your yogi also has got dvaita darshana during the vyavahara dasha. You need not accuse the Viveki as having dvaita darshana during the vyavahara. Both are in the same boat. Vaitasya pratibhanam tu vyavahare dvayo samam samadhau neti chetadvat nadvaitatva vivekinah vyavahare tu vaitasya pratibhanam vayuhu samam vyavahare tu vaitasya pratibhanam vayuhu samam. Samadhau and dvaita darshanam. Samadhau and dvaita darshanam. Na iti chet. Na iti chet. Sandhi is like this. Tadvat na advaitatva vivekinah. Sandhi break. Chet tadvat na advaitatva vivekinah. Now you take this anvaya. Samadhau na iti chet. Advaitatva vivekinaha. Add there. Api viveka dashaya. Advaitatva vivekinaha. Api viveka dashayam. To be added. Na. Means dvaita darshanam na bhavati. Na. Dvaita darshanam. Vyavahare tu dvaitasya pratibhanam dvayoho samam. During the dealings with the world, in the case of both, who are those? Viveki and Yogi, dvaita darshanam samam. Tulyam. In both cases, we do find dvaita darshanam means Yogi also appreciates the dvaita during the vyavahara. Viveki also appreciates the dvaita during the vyavahara. Okay, we'll see the next time. Thank you. Yeah.
Punirbhaya. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. Sarve Santu Niramaya. Sarve Pashyami Pashyantu. Maharshi Dukhapahare. Asato Ma Satyamaya. Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya. Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate.